अस्सलाम वालेकुम क्लास 7, आई विश यू ऑल अ वेरी गुड डे एंड अ वेरी गुड हेल्थ। और राइट क्लास, यू नो दैट वी आर डूइंग आवर वोकैबुलरी लेसन नंबर 2 एंड टुडे इज अ थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ आवर लेसन नंबर 2 एंड दिस इज गोइंग टू बी आवर 49th लेक्चर। और राइट, प्लीज ओपन योर अंडरस्टैंड एंड कम्युनिकेट बुक नंबर 2, लेसन नंबर टू। ओपन द सेकेंड लेसन ऑफ वोकैबुलरी, come to part C, right? Second lesson of vocabulary and come to part C. It is 192, page number 192, all right? I hope you have all opened page 192. Now kindly add the date on the left side of exercise C, today's date, so you know that we have done this work today. But you know, just leave it for now, just write the date, because I have told you always to carry a pencil in your hand, and after writing the date, just leave it, alright? Because there is a video I want to show you, but let me first tell you what it's about. Just look at the title. It is association. Association, right? Which words are you know, associated, you know, they are connected to each other. There is a sense of belonging, sense of association, all right? So association means that over here it means that, you know, that there are words, a group of words, and you have to find out that which words associate with each other, which words, you know, have, there's a feeling of belonging. They can belong in, you know, they can belong in any way. For example, if I am talking about, you know, a boy, a dog, a cat, a house, and then I say Faisal Mosque, right? So which word is the odd one out here? Which word does not belong? You will think about it. You will say, okay, cat and a boy or a building, they are all common nouns. But Faisal Mosque, it is a proper noun. So Faisal Mosque does not belong with the other group of words, right? So this is what we are going to do today. You have to find out that which words are belonging to each other and which words, you know, in any way. They can belong in any way. It can be a common noun, proper noun, concrete noun, abstract noun, or, you know, maybe, you know, it's a set of tools and, you know, there are tools in a group, and there's another example of something which is maybe a shirt. It does not belong with the tools, right? There are some gardening tools or kitchen tools or gardening tools or, you know, any tools, right? And then, you know, suddenly you find a shirt there, you know that it does not belong. And if there are some kitchen items like plate, you know, dishes or crockery, right, cup, mug, spoons, and then you see a football. So you will instantly know that the football does not belong. Why? Because it is not related to the items in the kitchen, right? So this is what association over here means. It's because you just have to find out that which words belong, and just have to find out there is only one word which does not belong, right? Just, you know, to clarify this concept and for you to have a better understanding, I would like to share a video with you, all right? Alright class, I just showed you a video in which a teacher was playing a game with her class fellows. She was asking them about, you know, a word which did not belong with the rest of the words. So the students had to, you know, pick out one word which was not belonging or which was not relating to the other set of words, the other group of words. Okay, I would like to share some slides with you. Look at this example. You have to pick out one word which does not belong with the others. Look at your example. Plate, glove, branch, table. So which word do you think does not belong with the others? Plate, glove, branch, table. Now look over here. Plate, glove and table, you know what is common in them? They are all man-made things. They are made by a man. Whereas a branch is a product of nature. It's a thing of nature, right? It is not made by a man. A branch is a natural thing. So, branch does not belong with the others. Now, let's look at this, these examples. Which word does not belong? Look over here. Mother, uncle, sister, grandma. Find out which word does not belong. Uncle does not belong because mother, sister, grandma, they are all females, right? They are all females, whereas uncle is a male. So uncle does not belong here. Come to the second question. Which word does not belong? Father, uncle, grandma, brother. Can you find out? Very good. It is grandma. Grandma does not belong. Why? Because father, uncle and brother are all males. Grandma is a female. So, grandma does not belong. Number three. Which word does not belong? Aunt, uncle, cousin, parent. Aunt, uncle and cousin. They are, you know, not such close relations as that of a parent, right? The parents are the closest relation or relative, you know, one has, right? A parent is a part of your family, right? A parent is a family. Whereas aunt, uncle and cousin, they are all relatives, right? So, parent is a family, is a member of your family. Whereas aunt, uncle and cousin, they are relatives. So, a parent does not belong, right? Number four. Which word does not belong? TV, movie, radio, DVD. Can you find out? It is radio, right? Because TV, movie and DVD are all the things that you can watch. But radio is something you cannot watch anything on it. You listen to it. So radio does not belong, right? In number three, parent did not belong because parent is not a relative. Parent is your family. It's the closest relation anyone can have. Whereas aunt, uncle, cousins, they're all relatives, right? So that is how parent did not belong. And radio does not belong because it is something you hear. You listen to, right? You listen to a radio. You don't watch. Which word does not belong? Question number five. Girl, boy, king. Girl, because boy and king are, you know, males, whereas a girl is a female. Girl does not belong. Come to number six. Which word does not belong? Slide, pool, swing, teeter, totter. Teeter, totter does not belong because, you know, when you go to a pool, you can see a slide there as well as, you know, swings are there as well, right? So, teeter-totter does not belong. Number seven, which word does not belong? Sand, waves, water, dirt. When you go to a beach, what do you see? You can see the water, the waves in the water and the sand. But dirt is something which does not belong to the things you see on a beach, right? So dirt does not belong here. Alright class, now find the one that does not belong. Yen, lira, dollar, ounce. You know that yen, lira and dollar are related to money, whereas ounce is not. So ounce does not belong. Now you have to choose a noun that does not belong to the group. Building, city, Mount Everest, country. You know that building, city and country are all common nouns, whereas Mount Everest is a proper noun. So Mount Everest does not belong to the group, right? Now please open your page number 191 and Come to exercise number C, association. I hope you know by now what is the meaning of association. You have to find out some association between the words, some connection, some relation, right? A relationship. So I will do the first one for you. I will do in fact two for you. You are going to do the rest yourself. Now, the question is, from each list, pick out the word which does not belong. Class, you are going to do it on your Understand and Communicate book number 2. This work will be done on your book. You have to circle the one word which does not belong. Number A, enemy, foe, opponent, adversary, partner. You know that enemy, foe, opponent, adversary, they are all the same thing, right? They are the enemies or, you know, competing against each other, right? Partner is an opposite word, it does not belong. So you have to circle the word partner. Come to B, polite, courteous, haughty, gallant, civil. You know, polite, courteous, and gallant and civil have same meanings. They are, you know, related to one another. They, you know, there is some similarity in them. But haughty means to be proud, arrogant, you know, to treat others like, you know, just you are just important, the others are not. To have a pride, you know, to act like, you know, to act proud, to have some arrogance. So haughty does not belong with the other group of words. You have to circle haughty. Come to C. Public, people, masses, populace, individual. D. District, continent, province, village, commune. Commune means to talk to each other, to communicate, to discuss. E. Exhausted, lazy, fatigued, tired, weary. F. Insignificant, tiny, puny, small, little. Puny also means, you know, small. G. Support, maintain, provide, boycott, sustain. Boycott means, you know, to have, to refuse to have any relationship or any dealing with anything, you know, something. H. Prudent, careful, reckless, cautious, discreet. Cautious means to be very careful. And discreet is to be, you know, being careful, right? Reckless means, you know, someone who is irresponsible, who does not care much. I. Alien, foreigner, native, stranger, immigrant. You know, foreigner is someone, you know, who belongs to another country. And stranger, or someone, you know, who is stranger for you, you don't know that person. It can be an alien for you. Immigrant is someone, you know, he goes to another country. A native is a person who belongs to one place. J. Develop, stagnate, mature, ripen, improve. So, you know, some development has come. You know, mature is, you know, you're growing. Ripen, a fruit is ripening or improving. Stagnate means something which remains still, right? And, you know, if you come to E also, exhausted means, you know, you're tired. Fatigued also means tired, very, you know, I'm tired and, you know, and lazy, you know, someone who doesn't like to do things, who's not very active, right? C, you know, if you talk about public, people, masses, populace, individual. Populace is a difficult word, a complicated one. Populace means also related to population, right? Alright, class, this is your homework for today. It will be done on your book, Understand and Communicate 2. You have to circle the one word which does not belong. Alright, class, wish you all the very best. Allah Hafiz.